Shalom, Israel. You know, all praises to Yahweh, Bashim, Mashiach, Yahushai. It's your brother, from Ikebar, the true Hebrews under God, aka Thug. To my left,
Benjamin Monaghan.
And to my right,
Maya Yashal from Charles Simeon.
Okay, so what we're about to do, we're about to go over and prove that the Native Americans are Israelites, you know what I mean, since Thanksgiving is coming up, you know what I mean, so we're just going to make this video for our brothers from the tribe of Gad. So we're going to start off with John chapter 8, verse 32.
John chapter 8, verse 32. And ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free.
So the truth, we're going to prove that the Native Americans are Israelites. Without a shadow of a doubt, we're going to prove it. So, our first book we're going to use Christopher Columbus and the participation of the Jews in Spanish and Portuguese discovery. So we're going to use this and read page 14 and 15, my brother.
Page 14. This book interested Columbus so much that he accepted three whole chapters. He was also very fond of reading the Bible and the fourth book of Ezra, which was probably written by the Jew who lived outside of Palestine.
Continue.
According to his own assertion, the incentive that impelled him to plan his discovery was not a love of science.
So he didn't find America because of science. Go ahead.
But his interpretation of the prophecies of Isaiah.
So he used the Bible to find the new world. Now read this. This is another book called Lost Tribes of the Promised Land by Ronald Sanders. Read verse 77. Highlighted part.
Verse 77. All his life, Columbus' ideas about geography were permeated with a peculiar religious mysticism.
Go ahead.
He kept a book of prophecies in which he collected quotes, mostly from the Bible.
So he had his little notepad, you know what I mean? It's full of notes dealing with the Bible. Go ahead.
Often those dealing with idols far off. They seem to prophesy his own discovery.
So he's dealing with the islands and countries far off. So that's how he understood about the Americas, because he was dealing with the Bible. He knew that the world wasn't flat, because in Isaiah, tell you that the earth is round. So he knew that. You see what I'm saying? So get 2nd Ezra 13 and 40.
2nd Ezra 13 and 40. Those are the 10 tribes which were carried away prisoners out of their own land in the time of Hosea the king, whom Solomon Nasser, the king of Assyria, led away captive.
So hold that. Now continue reading that slightly.
And he carried them over the waters, and so came they into another land.
So now give me, in that book, Christopher Columbus, page 96 and 97. Read verse 40 again.
2nd Ezra chapter 13, verse 40.
Uh-huh.
Those are the 10 tribes.
So we all know during the time of King Solomon's death, the kingdom split. You had the northern kingdom, which consists of 10 tribes, and you had the southern kingdom, which consists of 2 tribes. Go ahead.
Which were carried away prisoners out of their own land
In
the time of Hosea the king, whom Solomon Nasser, the king of Assyria, led away captive.
Go ahead.
And he carried them over the waters. And so came they into another land.
So he was brought into another land. So now read page 96 and 97.
Page 96.
Matter of fact, just read that part right there.
The Portuguese Marrano of Villaflor, who, strange to say, also called himself Montesinos, and afterwards assumed the name Aaron Levi, informed Manessa that he had mingled in South America the Jews of 10 tribes.
Of who?
Of the 10 tribes.
So he understood that he was dealing with the Jews of the 10 tribes down in South America. So how can all the proof is in the book and the Bible? This is just historical proof that the further proof that the Native Americans and Hispanics are Israelites. So he said he dealt with the 10 tribes when he came over here. Now read Lost Tribes of Promised Land, page 148.
1:48.
So let's see where the Native Americans come from. Read that.
We have always believed that his descendants have to come and subjugate this land and make us their vessels. Now, since you state that you come from the directions where the sun rises.
Where do Native Americans come from?
The direction where the sun rises.
So where did the sun rise? In the east and sets in the west. So they came from the east. Go ahead.
And because of what you tell us about the great Lord or King who sent you here.
So they understood the great Lord sent the 10 northern tribes there. Let's talk about what the world calls Jesus Christ, Yahweh Shai. He sent the 10 northern tribes over here. Go ahead.
We believe and hold it for certain that he is our natural Lord.
So that's it on that. Then go back to the second Ezra 30. Because Christ came as angels all the time. That's why I said he's going to further prove that. Continue. Verse 41.
But they took this counsel among themselves, that they would leave the multitude of the heathen and go forth into a further country where never mankind dwelt.
Because Japheth dwelt in what you call Europe, Shem populated the Middle East, and then Ham had Africa. The only place that was not inhabited was the Americas. That's why it's called the New World. Continue.
That they might there keep their statutes, which they never kept in their own land.
Why? Give me Hosea. Hold that. Give me Hosea chapter 4, verse 16.
Give me page 99 of that.
So Hosea chapter 4. So they came over here to try to get their life together, to try to get right with the Most High. Hosea 4, 16 and 17.
Hosea 4 and 16.
So what was happening to the northern tribe? Go ahead.
For Israel slideth back as a backsliding heifer. Now the Lord will feed them as a lamb in a large place.
And where?
As a lamb in a large place.
Which is America. This is a large place. The Americas, North, South, Central American Highland. This is a large place. And we was slaughtered. Go ahead.
Ephraim is joined to idols.
So Ephraim represents the northern kingdom. It says what?
Ephraim is joined to idols. Let him alone.
So the northern tribe was carried away to dumb idols. They was into idolatry, just like the so-called Hispanic Americans are into this day. Now check this out. Read back to the book Christopher Columbus and the Participation of the Jews in Spanish and Portuguese Discoveries. Read, starting with this.
Circumcision prevailed among the Indians.
So the Native Americans practiced circumcision. It tells you in Genesis 17 that the Most High made a covenant with Abraham to circumcise his kid. Why would some heathens be doing this? Continue.
They often bathe in rivers and streams. They refrain from touching the dead.
So they refrain from touching the dead. Because why? When you touch the dead, you go to the law, you're unclean for 7 days. Go ahead.
The dead and from tasting blood.
From tasting what?
From tasting blood.
Somebody get that door for the girl. So for tasting blood. So they refrain from tasting blood. Continue.
They had definite fast days.
So our people have fast days. Go ahead.
Marrying with sisters-in-law was permitted if they were childless widows.
That's in the Bible as well, in the law, that if a man dies, that brother takes on that man's wife. That's in the law. Go ahead.
Wives were discarded for a new helmet. Helmets. They also sacrificed the first fruits.
They did what?
They also sacrificed first fruits.
So they sacrificed the first fruits. Go ahead.
On a high mountain. And understood shady trees. And under shady trees. They had temples.
They had what?
They had temples.
So just like the Hebrews had temples, the so-called Native Americans had temples. Go ahead.
Carried a holy ark.
They did what?
Carried a holy ark.
Which the holy ark was what? The Ark of the Covenant. Go ahead.
Before them. Times of war. They were also like the 10 tribes, inclined into idol worship.
So it was, read that part again, the last part, 10 tribes inclined.
They were also like the 10 tribes, inclined to idol worship.
So just like in Hosea chapter 4, what we just read, verse 17, that the northern tribe, Ephraim, was joined to idols. The northern tribe, they had the Ark of the Covenant. They was practicing, they was trying to get right with the Most High, But they still had those idols, them same idols that they was following from Egypt, from Babylon. They still had those same idols that they followed. Now go back to 2 Ezra 13, start at verse 43.
Second Ezra 13, verse 43.
Go ahead.
And they entered into Euphrates. Euphrates by the narrow passages of the river.
Because when you're dealing with the Middle East, they went down through Euphrates, through the Persian Gulf, to the Indian Ocean. Common sense. Go ahead.
For the Most High didn't shoot signs for them.
Because Issachar dealt with the signs. He was into astrology. He understood that Issachar gave that blessing. He read, I believe, in Chronicles. Continue.
And hell still a flood.
So when you look up that word flood, in the Greek, a lot of people say, oh, they can't have no flood in the water. First of all, that's slow because Mississippi River have floods all the time. So Euphrates, when you look up that word flood in the Greek, it's potamos, strong number G4215, which means a stream, a river, or water. So he hell stood the water. Go ahead.
Till they were passed over.
Uh-huh.
For through that country, there was a great way to go.
For through that country, there was a great way to go. Go ahead.
Namely, a year and a half.
So it took us a year and a half. Read verse 45 again. Because a lot of brothers, they stumble with 2 Ezra 13, 45, because it says they went through Arsuris. Let's see. Read that one again.
Verse 45. For through that country, there was a great way to go.
So when it says, for through that country, there was a great way to go, semicolon. A lot of brothers don't understand English. Why do you use semicolons? We're going to further prove why we're supposed to use a semicolon. Continue.
Namely, a year and a half.
Colon. Go ahead.
And the same region is called Arsuris.
So when you use a semicolon, you can change it around and still have the same meaning. You put it when you have two sentences and you combine and it means the same thing. So I should be able to use and flip it around and have the same meaning. For instance, if I've said, namely of a year and a half, colon, for through that country it was a great way to go, semicolon, and the same region is called Arsuris, you have a better understanding. That's where you put a semicolon there. But a lot of brothers don't understand that. It's the reason why it's a semicolon there. It's two different sentences, but meaning similar, but it relates. Now look up the word Arsuris in the Jewish Encyclopedia. We get that. Read that part again, verse 45.
Verse 45. For through that country, there was a great way to go, namely of a year and a half.
Uh-huh.
And the same region is called Arsuris.
It's called what?
Arsuris.
So we're going to look up that word Arsuris. Bear with me. Let me see if I got it. Read that right there. Matter of fact, I got to read it. It says, the name of the land beyond the great river, far away from the habitation of man, in which the 10 tribes of Israel would dwell, observing the law of Moses, until the time of restoration, according to 2 Ezra chapter 13, verse 45. Christopher Columbus identified America with this land. So they understood that Christopher Columbus identified America with the land of Arsuris, because Arsuris means Newfoundland. So give me Genesis 49. I mean, there's more than enough proof out there to prove who the northern tribes is, but we just gonna focus on Gad. So Genesis 49, verse 1.
Genesis 49, verse 1.
Go ahead.
And Jacob called unto his sons,
uh-huh,
and said, gather yourselves together,
uh-huh,
that I may tell you that which shall befall you in the last day.
So this was going to happen to the Israelites in the last day. So we all know when Yahweh stepped on the scene, we read Hebrews chapter 1, that was the marking of the last days. Now jump down to Gad, verse 19. You get 1 Chronicles 12 and 8.
Genesis 49, verse 19.
Go ahead.
Gad, a troop shall overcome him,
uh-huh,
but he shall overcome at the last.
So Gad was overcame by a troop. What troop was that? The U.S. Cavalry. The U.S. Cavalry came by, who was that president? Andrew Jackson. And they overcame the tribe of Gad and so-called Native Americans. But then now you have Native Americans waking up. You know, we got so-called Native Americans in our camp. And throughout the camps, throughout the world, is brother Native Americans waking up. Because just like Christ said, my sheep hear my voice. And these northern tribes are waking up. It's Bible prophecy. So read 1 Chronicles chapter 12, verse 8. And you give me Deuteronomy 33.
1 Chronicles chapter 12, verse 8. In the Gadites, there were separations of unto David. Unto the whole, to the wilderness. Men of might.
So the Native Americans, the Gadites, was mighty warriors. Go ahead.
And men of war.
Men of who?
Men of war.
The Native Americans was a hard tribe to take down. The Gadites was a hard time to take down. The white people, they had to go create the gelatin gun to defeat the Native Americans. It was that skillful in war. Go ahead.
Fit for the battle. That could handle shields. And bucklers. Whose faces were like the faces of lions.
So they was able to handle all different type of weaponry. And they used to paint their face like lions. They used to take war paint and face them when they went to war. Native Americans was well known for that. They still do that to this day with the powwows and different things. And their different feasts and stuff. So give me Deuteronomy chapter 33, verse 20 and 21. You can recite the Chronicles chapter 11, verse 13 and 14. Deuteronomy 33, verse 20.
Deuteronomy 33, verse 20.
Go ahead.
And of Gad he said, blessed be he that enlargeth Gad. He dwelt as a lion. And teareth the arm with the crown of the head.
So when it says dwell like a lion, he's a hunter, a predator. He hunts. And it says he did what?
He teareth the arm with the crown of the head.
So the Native Americans was known for what? Anybody know?
Scalping.
He teareth the crown with what?
He teareth the crown with the arm. He teareth the arm with the crown of the head.
He uses his arm to scalp people. Taking people's heads off, scalping people. Native Americans was known for that. Continue.
And he provided the first part for himself. Because there, in a portion of the lawgiver, was he seated.
So when all the 10 tribes came over here, Gad was given the lawgiver. Why? Hold that. Give me 2 Chronicles chapter 11, verse 13 and 14. 13 and 14.
2 Chronicles chapter 11.
Verse 13 and 14.
Verse 13. And the priests and the Levites that were in all Israel resorted to him. Resorted him out of all their coasts.
Go ahead.
The Levites left their suburbs and their possessions.
So the Levites left the suburbs, go ahead.
And their possessions. To Judea.
So the Levites left and came to Jerusalem, Judea, go ahead.
And Jerusalem.
For
Jeroboam and his sons had cast them off.
So the Levites was cast out by Jeroboam. Who are the Jeroboam is the leader of the northern kingdom. So that's why read the last verse. So we know that Levi was cast out from the priesthood with the northern tribes because it was war between the northern and southern kingdom. So read Deuteronomy 33 and 21.
Deuteronomy 33 and 21.
Go ahead.
And he provided the first part for himself.
So when he got here, the Native Americans, the Gadites, they got the most of the land. The majority of the land they took. They took Canada and the majority of America. Go ahead.
Because they're in a portion of the lawgiver.
So Gad was the ones that was supposed to keep the other tribes in check. Go ahead.
Was he seated? And he came with the heads of the people.
Who was the heads? Of the northern kingdom, Ephraim. Go ahead.
He executed the justice of the Lord and his judgments with Israel.
So he dealt with the law. That's it on that?
Yes, sir.
So he dealt with the law. You see what I'm saying? That's why still Native Americans still have that law within them. You see what I'm saying? Like the way they dress. You know what I mean? They're not restrained from different foods. You know what I mean? The rest of the, I mean, a lot of Native Americans is under that curse. You know what I mean? But some of them are, a lot of them are waking up now. You know, so now give me Numbers 15:37. You give me Deuteronomy 22 and 12. Because Native Americans was well known for wearing fringes. And we got, you know, images out there. We're going, you know, when I edit the video, I'm going to put the images out there to show the Native Americans wear long. Garments. That's not a heathen custom. That's an Israelite custom. They talking about all the Chinese have fringes. No. First of all, they got plain little garments. The Native Americans' garments was royalty. They still stand out because what Israel got flavor. We go all in with how we dress, and that's how the Native Americans with their garments they go all in. So give me Numbers 15:37.
Numbers 15:37.
Go ahead.
And the Lord spake unto Moses, saying, speak unto the children of Israel.
No, speak unto the Chinese.
Speak unto the children of Israel.
So he's speaking to the children of Israel. Go ahead.
And bid them that they make fringes in the borders of their garments.
So that's why Native Americans wear fringes, because that was a commandment that Moses gave to the 12 tribes of Israel. He didn't give the Chinese that commandment. Continue.
Throughout their generation.
That means forever. That's why the Native Americans, even though they got conquered and they was brought to reservation, put on reservation, they was brought up to Indian boarding schools and they cut their hair and they practiced, or they talked them and changed their languages and stuff, or combined it with the native tongue or Hebrew with English or French. That's what they did. But they still, to this day, 2014, you go to any powwow, you're going to see Native Americans wear fringes and border blue. On some of their garments. Continue.
And that they put upon the fringe of the borders of a ribbon of blue.
Continue.
And it shall be unto you for a fringe, that ye may look upon it, and remember all the commandments of the Lord, and do them.
And that's why Native Americans are waking up. Because now they're looking at those fringes and say, hold up. You got Judah, you know, Judah grows up first and start teaching the other tribes who they are. And now the northern tribes is waking up in these last days. You know what I mean? Continue.
And that they seek not after your own heart, and your own eyes, after ye used to go a whoring.
Because the northern tribe was, all 12 tribes fell off. The 10 northern tribes was into idolatry to the T. Continue.
That they may remember and do all my commandments and be holy unto your God.
And that's why the Native Americans, they are remembering, oh man, what we did was wrong. Because why we get punished? Our Creator must, we must ain't doing something right. And so that's why a lot of them are waking up. Continue.
I am the Lord your God, which brought you out of the land of Egypt. To be your God. I am the Lord your God.
So that's the Lord, or Yahweh in the Hebrew. So give me Deuteronomy 22 and 12.
Deuteronomy chapter 22 and 12. Thou shalt make thee fringes upon four quarters of thy vesture.
So like I said, the Americans is well known for putting fringes, not just on the border, but putting fringes on their shoulders, on their arms, on their legs, everything. They got fringes all over. Like I said, a lot of powwows and stuff, like you see those, you know, Native Americans dressing up and stuff, they be looking, man, no garments be looking cold. You know what I mean? I be wondering, like, hey, help me out, brother, you know what I mean? Like, real talk. Now give me Genesis 25:27.
Genesis 25 and 27.
Because the Native Americans was well known for what? Dwelling in tents, or what they call teepees. Let's see where they get that from. Genesis 25:27. Give me Numbers 24:5.
Genesis 25 and 27.
Go ahead.
And the boys grew. And Esau was a cunning hunter. A man of the field. And Jacob was a plain man, dwelling in tents.
And that's why the Native Americans was known for dwelling in teepees or tents. Give me Numbers 24 and 5.
Numbers chapter 24, verse 5. How goodly are thy tents, O Jacob.
Read that one more time.
How goodly are thy tents, O Jacob.
How goodly are the tents of Jacob. That's why the Americans was known for dwelling in teepees. Ain't nothing but another word for teepee, tent. Now give me Leviticus 23, verse 10.
Leviticus 23, verse 10. Speak unto the children of Israel, and say unto them, when ye be come into the land which I give unto you, and shall reap the harvest thereof, then ye shall bring a sheaf of the first fruits.
A what?
A sheaf of the first fruits.
So the Israelites are supposed to bring a first fruit, go ahead.
Of your harvest.
Uh-huh.
Unto the priest.
Uh-huh.
And he shall wave the sheaf before the Lord to be accepted for you.
So they dealt with the, read that part again.
Speak unto the children of Israel.
No, speak unto the Chinese.
Speak unto the children of Israel.
The Africans.
Children of Israel.
White men.
The children of Israel.
The team.
And say unto them, when ye become into the land which I give unto you,
uh-huh,
and shall reap the harvest thereof,
uh-huh,
then ye shall bring a sheaf of the first fruits.
Of the what?
Of the first fruits.
Hold that. Read. Christopher Columbus and participation of the Jews in Spanish and Portuguese discovery. Again. Read that part right there. They also sacrifice.
They also sacrifice the first fruit.
They did what?
They also sacrifice the first
fruit. Hold that. What did they do? Verse 10.
When ye be come into the land which I give unto you,
uh-huh,
and shall reap the harvest thereof,
continue,
then ye shall bring a sheaf of the first fruits.
Of the what?
Of the first fruits.
What did the Americans do?
They also sacrifice the first fruit.
They did what?
They also sacrifice the first fruits.
Why would heathens do this? This was only a law that was given to the Israelites. Continue.
On the high mountain.
On where?
On the high mountain.
Continue.
And under shade trees.
Go ahead.
They had temples.
They had what?
They had temples.
Just like Solomon built the temple, the Americans had temples. Go ahead.
And carry a holy ark.
Just like when we went to war, we had that holy ark. Go ahead.
Before them.
Uh-huh.
In times of war.
A time of what?
In times of war.
Just like the Bible, we did that. Go ahead.
They were also like the 10 tribes, inclined to idol worship.
So because we read 2 Chronicles, like we'll put all of the precepts so y'all brothers can see, when we read 2 Chronicles 35, I believe, like when we went to war, we had the holy ark with us. And only certain people can touch that, only the priests. You see what I'm saying? So now give me Deuteronomy 28. Deuteronomy chapter 28. I mean, there's so much evidence out here, I can't even cover everything. I'm just touching little bases. I'm not even going too deep because it's brothers already went deep into this. Brothers already broken down lovely. So with all the brothers that, like, just because Bug can't make a video about proving who the Native Americans is from the tribe of Gad, that doesn't mean that those brothers is already stuck in their mind saying, those are not my people, they Chinese. We're not making this video for y'all. We making this video for the elect, the people that can have an ear to hear. That's what we making this video for. All the scoffers and all the brothers that gangsters or brothers that don't believe, it's not for you. Continue doing what you do, we don't do what we gotta do. So read that, Deuteronomy 28 verse 15.
Deuteronomy 28 verse 15.
Uh-huh.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe, to do all his commandments and his statutes, which I command this day,
uh-huh,
that all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
So the Israelites will be cursed. We all know that. So a lot of people say, oh, the Native Americans don't fit this prophecy. Well, let's go into a few of these curses and see if the Native Americans don't fit it. Read verse 15.
Curse shall not be in the city.
So we live right here in Minnesota, in Minneapolis. And we have a big Native American population of the community. And you see the Native Americans are cursed in the city as well. They're living right next to Judah, so-called Negroes, and next to Hispanics. They're right in the hood. They're poor. You know, I had this debate with this one sister talking about Native Americans make 500,000 plus.
What?
So let me go tell this homeless Native American on the floor, on the street, homeless, or this Native American sister that's prostituting to make ends meet. Hey, what you doing homeless? What you doing prostituting? You make $500,000 a year. How simple are y'all people? They taking these bogus statistics and trying to run with it. Read that part again, verse 15. Verse 16, I mean.
Cursed shall thou be in the city.
The Native Americans are cursed in the city. Go ahead.
And cursed shall thou be in the field.
They wasn't even cursed in the field. If you understand, Native Americans was picking cotton as well. A lot of people don't know that. History. I have, on my mom's side, let's go back to Native Americans, they was there. I even knew a sister that was, her grandfather, Native American, he even told, and he was, a Mexican, he even said he was picking cotton right next to, his forefathers picking cotton next to the Black Americans. So what are y'all talking about? Now read verse 21.
Verse 21.
Go ahead.
The Lord shall make thee pestilence cleave unto thee.
So many pestilence diseases cleave unto the natives. A major one was smallpox. That wiped out millions. Continue.
Until he had consumed thee.
Until what?
Until he had consumed thee.
So these so-called Negroes that are saying that didn't happen to the Americans, they must not know history. A lot of these brothers probably failed history class in high school, don't have no education when it comes to, they have no knowledge of history, because they even show you pictures of the Americans with smallpox. Go ahead.
Until he have consumed thee from off the land, whither thou goest to possess it.
Go ahead.
The Lord shall smite thee with a consumption, and with fever, and with an inflammation, and with an extreme burning, and with the sword, and with blasting, and with mildew, that they shall pursue thee until perish.
So when the U.S. cavalry came up against the Native Americans, they destroyed them with the pest and with the diseases. If that didn't kill them, they used other tactics as blasting, which is what? Using that gun. That's Bible prophecy. Now, give me verse 31 to 34.
Verse 31. Thine ox shall be slain before thine eyes, and thou shalt not eat thereof.
What happened?
Thine ox shall be slain before thine eyes, and thou shalt not eat thereof.
You have that book with that buffalo? What's it say? What's it say? No more buffalo. No, wait, read that part again.
Thine ox shall be slain before thine eyes, and thou shalt not eat thereof. Thine ass shall be violently taken away from thee before thy face, and thou shalt not be restored to thee.
So what the Edomites did, so-called white men did, was he killed all the buffaloes. You see what I'm saying? Because the Native Americans was into, they ate healthy. They ate vegetables and fruits and corn. You know what I mean? They ate lamb and sheep and goat and stuff. But what the white man did, he killed the animals and then let loose wild pigs. And like, go ahead. And our people, they had no food to eat. So what they did, they resorted to eating that pig. Because pigs is not indigenous to America. That's indigenous to Europe. A lot of brothers don't know that. No, read that. What did I say, 31?
Yeah.
Oh, were you left? Yeah, 31. Read that out.
Thine ox shall be slain before thine eyes. And thou shalt not eat thereof.
Thine
ass shall be violently taken away from thee before thy face.
Continue.
And shall not be restored to thee.
Go ahead. Because it wasn't restored back to them. This is so-called Native Americans' land. Y'all think because they got a few casinos and only a few handful of people get money? Y'all think they're not our people, they got casinos. But how many so-called Native Americans reaping the benefit for that? They stole the whole land from Native Americans. They gave them a couple few casinos. And y'all brothers talking about that?
And Samaka, all the tribes that got casinos and stuff like that, those tribes sold out.
Gone. But y'all don't know that. Read that. That's too much knowledge for them. They don't know that. Read that.
Thy sheep shall be given unto thine enemy.
To that what?
Unto thine enemy.
And
thou shalt have none to rescue them. Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
What happened to the natives?
Thy sons and thy daughters shall be given unto another people.
Common sense. That happened to the natives. Like I said earlier, they set up boarding schools and shipped the kids and brought them to different states to indoctrinate them with their European philosophies. made them cut their hair, made them wear suits, take off their garments. Now they wear suits. Now they're looking like white folks. That happened to the natives. Mm-hmm. But if you don't know history, it's going over your head. And that's what it's doing to a lot of brothers. Continue.
And thine eyes shall look and fail with longing for them all the day long.
You don't think the Native Americans, the mothers and fathers, didn't want to save their children? Go ahead.
And there shall be no might in thine hand.
But they didn't have the power to get their kids back. Continue.
The fruit of thy land and all thy labors shall a nation which thou knowest not eat up.
Wait, hold on. So you're trying to say that they have the Native Americans? This is so-called Native Americans land. Didn't it? Strangers come over here and eat and reap the benefits. Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
The fruit of thy land and all thy labors shall a nation which thou knowest not eat up.
Because we over here, they way over there in the Caucasus Mountain in Europe and all that. We chilling. We didn't know these people, but they sure came over, took the land, and reaping the benefits now. Mm-hmm. Continue.
And thou shalt be only oppressed and crushed always.
We will always be oppressed. We are the oppressed nation. All 12 tribes. We all in the ghettos and the slums or in reservations. Y'all understand, the reservations is worse than the hoods. I don't know if a lot of these brothers haven't traveled or went anywhere, but the reservations is worse than the hood. I'd rather live in the worst hoods in the country, in the world, than live in a reservation. Mm-hmm. Y'all understand, these reservations, man, I visited a few of them, and it was horrible. I'm like, damn, y'all look like this. I'd be glad to go back to the hood in Minneapolis.
It's a lot, y'all. It's so bad in the reservations that they don't have regular stores. All the stores are like thrift stores, secondhand, used down stores. They don't have regular clothes.
Gone. Street.
Uh-huh. Gone. Continue reading that.
So that thou shalt be mad for the sight of thine eyes which thou shalt see.
So the Americans, you see them, they be mad as hell. You know what I mean? Especially, wow, man, that's why they turn to that alcohol. Because they is mad. So to release their pain, he said, man, let me turn to that drink. You see what I'm saying? Now read verse 37.
Verse 37.
Go ahead.
And thou shalt become an astonishment.
Uh-huh.
A proverb and a byword.
A proverb and a byword. Go ahead.
Among all nations, whither the Lord shall lead thee.
So they make him. Mock we are people. They call them Indians. Indian is a scavenger or beast. That's not what they call themselves. What else they call? What else type of ways they make mockery or
red skin?
Red skin.
Savages.
Huh?
Savages.
Scavengers. What else?
Indian givers.
Indian givers. You got the Kansas City Chiefs. Atlanta Braves. Mm-hmm. They make a mockery of it. Go ahead. Now read verse. Exactly, gone. Read verse 43.
Verse 43.
Go ahead.
The stranger that is within thee shall get up above thee very high.
So that did happen to Native Americans. The strangers, the so-called Europeans, came over here, and they got up above. Go ahead.
And thou shalt come down very low.
And the Native Americans are very low. They're right next to all the other brothers, so-called Negroes and Latinos. Go ahead.
He shall lend to thee.
So when Native Americans, they need loans or anything, they're going to go to the white man to lend, to get the money. Go ahead.
And thou shalt not lend to him.
You don't see no Native American. Where you see a bunch of Native American banks at? Where you see a bunch of our people saying, oh, we got to go and get a loan for the Native Americans. It's not there. Go ahead.
He shall be the head, and thou shalt be the tail.
Uh-huh.
Moreover, all these persons shall come upon thee, and shall pursue thee, and overtake thee. Till thou be destroyed.
Over 200 million native died throughout North, South, Central American islands. Wasn't that being destroyed? Go ahead.
Because thou hearkenest not unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
So because when the natives and the other 10 northern tribes came over here, we started living right at first, then we started falling off into Egypt, Egyptian customs and Babylonian customs and worshiping animals and suns and this and that. So that's why the Lord put us in captivity. Continue.
To keep his commandments and his statutes which he commanded thee.
Uh-huh.
That they shall be upon thee for a sign and for a wonder, and upon thy seed forever.
Uh-huh.
Because thou servest not the Lord thy God with joyfulness and with gladness of the heart, for the abundance of all things.
Continue.
Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies.
Therefore shalt what?
Therefore shalt thou serve thine enemies.
The Native Americans were slaves. A lot of people don't realize. So-called Native American and Spanish people was put in slavery first.
Which the Lord shall send against thee.
The Lord sent the Spaniards against us. He sent the French and England against us. Go ahead.
And hunger.
When the Native Americans want food, they have to go to the enemies. This is their land. Go ahead.
In hunger and in thirst.
Wait, hold on. This is their land. They said, I watched a documentary that they said, I just want some fresh water. We used to be able to drink from the streams. But now they got to pay for water. And I'm going to show you that's Bible prophecy. Go ahead.
And in nakedness.
They got clothes. Now they can't kill no buffalo to make clothes. Because you can't even hunt unless we have a hunting license. This is their land. Go ahead.
And in one of all things.
Wherever they want, Native Americans have to go to their enemies. Go ahead.
And he shall put a yoke of iron upon thy neck.
Uh-huh.
Until he have destroyed thee.
That happened to the Native. And we're going to prove it with images and everything when brothers watch the video. Continue.
The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far.
Ain't from Europe to America far. Common sense. Go ahead.
From the end of the earth.
Old world meets new world. Go ahead.
As swift as the eagle flies.
What was the Spaniards?
As swift as the eagle flies.
What was the French?
The eagle.
What was the British?
The eagle.
Go ahead.
A nation whose tongue thou shalt not understand.
We didn't understand their language. That's why they brought Hebrew interpreters. Matter of fact, read Lost Tribes of the Promised Land, page 92. Read that, my brother. So he said, Salakia said, a nation whose tongue thou shalt not understand. So how can they make peace treaties if the natives speaking, they're Chinese, because y'all brothers said they're teaching, they speak in Chinese, or they're Chinese. So if the Indians speaking Chinese, and the Spaniards were speaking Spanish, how can they make a covenant or a peace treaty? That's what Christopher Columbus is there. Read that.
We do not know much concerning Columbus' crew.
Uh-huh.
Of about 19 men aboard the three ships.
Go ahead.
But at least one of them was an Israelite.
Was a who?
Was an Israelite.
No, Chinese.
Was an Israelite.
Go ahead.
Whose presence as such was not merely accidental.
Uh-huh.
This was Luis de Torres.
Go ahead.
A convert of possibly only that year, who had once held a position with a government of Murcia.
Go ahead.
He was said to have known Hebrew.
No, Chinese.
Hebrew.
So the Chinese or the Native Americans are Chinese descent. Why did Christopher Columbus bring only Hebrew interpreters? Go ahead.
Aramaic.
Go ahead.
And Arabic.
Chinese.
Arabic.
Where's Chinese at then? If they're Chinese, why didn't he bring no Chinese interpreters? Read that part again.
He was said to have known Hebrew.
Hebrew.
Aramaic.
Uh huh.
And Arabic.
Go ahead.
And have been brought along by Columbus, especially as an interpreter.
As a who?
As an interpreter.
So he knew, Christopher Columbus knew where the 10 tribes was at, because he read the Bible. He said, we're going to get it. He even showed you in that book, in that movie, what's that book movie called? 1492, The Concourse of the New World or something like that. You know, I find a clip and put it in the video. But it shows in that clip that Christopher Columbus was talking to a Jesuit priest, and he was like, how do you know? He said, because Esdras did it, and the dude was like, Esdras was a Jew.
Die calculations of Toscanelli, morality, Esdras.
Esdras is a Jew.
So he was quoting Ezra. Esdras is just the Greek way of saying Ezra. So Christopher Columbus knew about this land because he read 2 Esdras 13:40-45. Continue, Bob.
He was said to have known Hebrew,
uh-huh,
Aramaic,
uh-huh,
and some Arabic.
Go ahead.
And had been brought along by Columbus, especially as an interpreter.
Go ahead.
One of the purpose of the voyage, as we have seen,
continue,
was to find the great Khan.
Was Khan or Kahan, which is priest, the great priest, go ahead.
And Taurus was to be the mouthpiece for his encounter.
So he was supposed to be the translator. Go ahead.
Presumably on the basis of his Hebrew.
No. He brought him over because he spoke that Chinese well.
His great Hebrew.
Because he spoke Hebrew well. So that's the only reason he brought that guy, because he spoke Hebrew. And he knew that the Hebrews. Now read, this is Christopher Columbus, back to this book, page 90.
I'm among the explorers, companions, whose name have come down to us, the complete list is lost.
Uh-huh.
There were several men of Jewish stock.
Uh-huh.
For example, least the Doris.
So one of them say they knew it was only at least one Israelite. Wait, this book says it was many. Go ahead.
A Jew.
A what?
A Jew.
Uh-huh.
Who had occupied a position under the government of Murcia.
Uh-huh.
And who was baptized shortly before Columbus sailed.
Continue.
As he understood Hebrew, Chaldee, and some Arabic.
Uh-huh.
Columbus employed him as an interpreter.
That's further proof. Now go back to Deuteronomy 28. So verse 49. Read that, brother.
Deuteronomy 28, verse 49.
Go ahead.
The Lord shall bring a nation against thee from far.
Spain to America, go ahead.
From the end of the earth.
Old world meets new world, go ahead.
As swift as the eagle flies.
Talking about the Romans and the Spaniards and all the other people that came over here. Go ahead.
A nation whose tongue thou shalt not understand.
Because the Europeans didn't speak our language. That's why he had to bring Israelites. He had to bring our brothers, Jews, Moors, over here to translate and or to make to make peace treaties amongst the natives, amongst the 10 tribes. Continue.
A nation of fierce continents.
Uh-huh.
We shall not regard the person of the old. Nor show favor to the young.
So they killed the old Native Americans. They killed the woman. They hung the woman upside down. They cut the woman that was pregnant, cut her baby, cut the stomach wide open. Stomp on the babies. Take the babies and bash it against the stone. Fed it to dogs. That's what they did. They didn't care about old or young. Woman, child, no matter what, they killed 200 million plus. Continue, Bob.
And ye shall eat the fruit of thy cattle and the fruit of thy land.
Ain't the white man reaping the benefits? Go ahead.
Until thou be destroyed.
Go ahead.
Which also shall not leave thee either corn, wine, or oil, or the increase of thine kind, or flocks of thy sheep. Until he had destroyed thee.
Why? Because the so-called white man is a greedy dog. A greedy dog. So he's not just gonna leave them. He don't want to leave them nothing. He want to take everything from them. And like the brother was saying, the only people that got little crumbs was the ones that was traitors. Now go back to read verse 54.
Verse 54.
Go ahead.
So that the man that is tender among you and very delicate, his eye shall be evil toward his brother.
That's all Bible prophecy. That's why you got these so-called Negroes that accepted Hispanics and Americans as brothers. Because their eyes evil toward their brother. That's why, you know, they might have been in the world and was into gangbanging or whatever, and one of the northern tribes, you know, they was beefing with their whole life. You know, they might have been hanging with the folks or the Blackstones or the Viceroys, and they was beefing with the Latin Kings or the Serenos or Brown Pride or whatever. Or one of their family members got taken out, or one of their best friends got taken out by a northern tribe, and then they said, that can't be my brother. He killed my best friend. He did this. But read verse 54.
So if the man that is tender among you and very delicate, his eye shall be evil toward his brother.
Ain't, when you go into the hood or any school or anything, you see blacks and Hispanics at war. Blacks and blacks at war. Hispanics and Hispanics are at war. You don't see too many other races come over here and they fight each other like that. Like, you got Issachar, so-called Mexicans, and Judah, so-called American Negroes, in California killing each other like animals. Why? Because they're under the curse. Continue.
And toward the wife of his bosom.
Uh-huh.
And toward the remnant of his children, which he shall leave.
Because a lot of Native Americans, they also leave their children alone too, behind too. A lot of them is not being nice to their women. A lot of them are beating the hell out of their women. That's Bible prophecy. Now read verse 60.
Verse 60. Moreover, he will bring upon thee all the diseases of Egypt, which thou was afraid of, and they shall cleave unto thee. Also every sickness and every plague, which is not written in the book of this law. Then will the Lord bring upon thee until thou be destroyed. And you shall be left few in number.
What was going to happen to the natives? To the Israelites?
And ye shall be left few in number.
Wasn't they left few? Mm-hmm. Wasn't they almost trying to exterminate them? Go ahead.
Whereas ye were as the stars of heaven.
It was tons of us over here. It was tons of us in Puerto Rico and Dominican Republic and South America, Central America, Mexico, and Americas. It was tons of us, millions and millions. But then we was few in number. Go ahead, left few in number. Go ahead.
For multitude.
Uh-huh.
Because thou wouldest not obey the voice of the Lord thy God.
Uh-huh.
And it shall come to pass that as the Lord rejoiced over you to do you good,
uh-huh,
and to multiply you, so the Lord will rejoice over you to destroy you and to bring you to naught.
And that's why they records brought to nothing. They live in on a land that belongs to them, and they're not even prevailing in it. They're not even exceeding in it. They're at the bottom. They're pushed in the slums right next to the rest of the brothers. Go ahead.
And ye shall be plucked from off the land whither thou goest to possess it.
The northern tribe came over here to try to get away from the heathens, and they still got plucked out of this land. No matter where we went, we try to escape. Okay, we gotta go over here. The Lord said, nope, you're being wicked. Come on, Esau. Conquer the 10 tribes. They came, plucked them out. Go ahead.
And the Lord shall scatter thee among all people.
You can't get away from these curses, no matter what. We was scattered. That's why you got Native Americans in Spain. You got Native Americans in Russia. You see what I'm saying? Go ahead.
From one end of the earth, even unto the other.
They brought 300 Taino Indians to Spain. They put hundreds of, maybe even thousands of South Americans, Inca Indians, and brought them to Hawaii. Why do you think a lot of people in Hawaii be like, my forefathers go back to people in Chile? Because I knew Hawaiian. I'm like, you don't look like a Hawaiian. You look more Hispanic. He's like, oh no, my great-great-grandfather is actually from Chile or Argentina. You see what I'm saying? Like, they know their history. How y'all get here? Man, we bought on boat, on ships. But they don't know that history. Go ahead.
And there thou shalt serve other gods, which neither thou nor thy fathers had known, even wood and stone.
Because you have a lot of natives that's into that Christianity too. They into worshiping into idol worship too. Go ahead.
And among these nations shalt thou find no ease, neither shall the sole of thy feet have rest. But the Lord shall give thee there a trembling heart.
Because the other day I was driving, it was like 2:00 in the morning. I'm driving down the street on the south side of Minneapolis. And just like the scripture says, they will have, neither should they so have, of thy feet have rest. 2:00-3:00 in the morning, I'm driving. I see prostitutes, Native Americans walking. Hey, trying to like, you know, that's under the curses. They walking back and forth looking for, to try to make some money because they're under those curses. But according to some Negroes, they pay $500,000 a year. Go ahead.
And it's a lot, Kim. And when you look at Minnesota, like I'm gonna say like 50% of the prostitution is all Native Americans.
Gone. That's what I saw. Continue out.
But the Lord shall give thee there a trembling heart, and failing of eyes, and sorrow of mind.
But like I said, when we out there teaching, and we've seen Native Americans, you look in their eyes and see the pain. Like I said, that's why they turn to that alcohol and drugs. Even the ones that's getting money from the casinos, a lot of them is into drugs, heavy drugs. Not just the weed, they doing coke and all that. Because they still feeling that pain for what their forefathers went through. Continue.
And thy life shall hang in doubt before thee, and thou shalt fear day and night, and shall have none assurance of thy life.
They don't even know how they gonna survive, how they gonna get a meal, how they gonna get fresh water. Go ahead.
In the morning thou shalt say, with God it were even. Uh-huh. And at even thou shalt say, with God it were morning. Uh-huh. For the fear of thine heart, wherewith thou shalt fear, and for the sight of thy eyes, which thou shalt see.
Go ahead.
And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
Like I said, Native Americans, so-called Spanish, was brought on ships to Spain, to Hawaii, to different parts of the world. The transatlantic slave trade started with the natives first. Then they brought the southern kingdom. But a lot of brothers don't understand that. Continue.
By the way, whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again. Uh-huh. And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
That's why, like I said, you got Mexicans in Spain. They even show you in old movies about like Mexicans and stuff, showing how they put them on ships and brought them. I'm going to find that clip and put it on the video when we edit everything.
Early in the legislature of California, a law was passed that virtually made Native Americans slaves. They were not allowed to travel freely. They could be stopped at any time. And if they couldn't show that they were attached to a white man or his farm, they could be picked up and incarcerated and given to another white man.
But there's a movie I watched, I forgot the name of it, but I'm finding it. They don't put in natives and Mexicans and different native tribes on ships and bring them to Spain, and using them as servants. Continue.
For bond men and bond women.
Slave man, slave women, go ahead.
And no man shall buy you.
No man shall redeem the natives, only their big brother Christ. Now give me the Lost Tribes of the Promised Land, page 143, I believe.
The moment.
So this is just extras. This is just give going into further proving
the moment of in solar expansion was increasing. In 1512, Juan Ponce de León, a relative of the Marquis of Cadiz, who had initiated the campaign against Granada 30 years before, took on Puerto Rico,
go ahead.
The toughest of the conquest.
So the when they was dealing with all the other natives, the Puerto Ricans was the hardest tribe, one of the hardest tribes. Go ahead, take that, go ahead.
So far, because of its Carib population.
Because of what?
Carib population.
Because they had, it was too many of them. Why was that? Let's go to Bible prophecy, Genesis 49, verse about Joseph.
Genesis 49, verse 24. But his bow abode in strength.
No, verse 22.
Verse 22. Joseph is a fruitful bow.
That's why Joseph is the so-called Puerto Rican, and Manasseh is the, or Ephraim is the Puerto Ricans, and Manasseh is the Cubans. So read that part again, so I can. Is the part where it's right here, Puerto Rico?
Puerto Rico, the toughest of the conquest so far because of its carried population.
Because Ephraim is Joseph is a fruitful bow. I'm saying Ephraim and Esther. Very fruitful. Again, bring out.
Let me get that idea.
Yeah.
Ronald's chief argument in supporting his view.
So this is back to the book Christopher Columbus and the partition of the Spanish and Portuguese.
Page 98,
go ahead.
Ronald's chief argument in supporting his view is the language of the Indians in Hispaniola, Cuba, and Jamaica.
Uh-huh.
And the adjoining islands. He commented that it was many reasons blessings to Hebrew.
To what?
To Hebrew.
Go ahead.
In fact, He even called it corrupted. He,
go ahead.
He asserted that such names as Cuba.
The such names as Cuba and what else?
And Haiti.
And Haiti is what?
Are Hebrew.
Are who?
Are Hebrew.
It's Hebrew words. Go ahead.
The names of the rivers of the Pison is used among the natives. Among the natives, or derivative from Hebrew.
So it derives from the Hebrew, go ahead.
For example, hyena from the Hebrew ayin. Stream, Yannis for Yoda. Yahweh from Jacob. Urus from Urias.
Go ahead.
Siabao from Siba.
Go ahead.
Maisi from Maisi.
So the Hebrew language and the native language were damn near exact because it was Hebrew. Go ahead.
Oh, it says
go ahead.
The name of their tools and their little canoes or canses, the names Asi for paper. The name of the storehouse for maize, grain, and like all points to the Hebrew language.
All points to what?
To the Hebrew language.
No Chinese.
To the Hebrew language.
No Japanese.
To the Hebrew language.
They spoke Hebrew. Now give me Lost Tribes and Promised Land 148.
I got something to say. You know how in the other book he was talking about how like the man he came up with posses of the Native Americans?
No, we're gonna get to that. Yeah, we got there. I read that one. Yeah, read the Lost Tribe 364. Read that, brother.
Hosea 7 and 8. Ephraim is half mixed himself among the people.
Ephraim, the northern kingdom, had mixed himself among the people. That's why a lot of us said, they're not my people. They're not black. You gotta be black. And they brown as hell. They light skin. They light skin. I may not be black. Black. Read that one more time.
Ephraim, he hath mixed himself among the people.
That's why, yes, the Native Americans was pretty dark, but they mixed themselves among the people. Some mixed with the Japanese and Chinese. Some mixed with the Spaniards and other Europeans. Go ahead.
Ephraim is a cake not turned. Strangers have devoured his strength. And he knoweth it not.
Because they also tell you that Ephraim is a silly dove. They don't really realize who their enemy is. You know what I mean? They love Esau dearly. They worship. That's how you know also the Northern tribe is, you know, so-called Spanish Americans. They take idolatry to a whole nother level. They got the white image on their back, on their chest, and they carve the bobblehead Jesus like, damn, where you get that at? Painted in their cars and stuff. There's a whole shop on Lake Street on the south side of Minneapolis. Issachar got, they got the white Cedric Borgia, white Jesus up everywhere. I'm talking about, they are hardcore when it comes to worshiping idols. They all up in the Catholic Church.
Every home that you go to, they got a picture of like white Jesus on like the top of it.
Answer that. So that's it on that. Now read that, brother. Or matter of fact, before you get that, get James and Deere. So I feel. Page 176.
The time is 4:45. The Minneapolis Central Library will be closing in 15 minutes.
Okay.
Thank you.
Hurry up a little bit. Matter of fact. Time. So this is the the history of the American Indians by James Deere. So we just gonna go to the table of contents, and matter of fact, I'm just gonna read a few of it with it, the different customs that neighbor had, and show you how it links up to the Hebrews. So the natives, they used the division into tribes. So just like when you go to Joshua 11:23, the 12 tribes, we did that as well. They worship Yahweh. When you go to Exodus 6:3, Their belief in the ministration of angels, when you go to Hebrews 1, 13 and 14, also Psalms 104, 3 and 4, it talks about how the angels minister. Their festivals, fast, and religious rites. Matter of fact, let me pull that one because it's going to show you the high holy days that they celebrated. Read this part right here.
Page 140. Their festival fast and religious rites have also a great resemblance to those of the Hebrews.
Uh-huh.
They kept every year a sacred feast called the Passover.
Wait, the Native Americans did what?
Called the Passover.
They were celebrating who?
Passover.
Uh-huh.
In memory of their deliverance from Egypt.
Oh my gosh.
Bondage.
Man.
That's a cut.
So
it's an innocent bondage labor.
So they also did, let me see, the laws of uncleanness. Like if a woman was unclean, the Native Americans, like I said, I'll put the, because we don't have that much time. You know, I put the picture or whatever, the page or whatever, where I got it from. But they practice uncleanness. So if a woman was on her monthly, they put her away for 7 days. That was a Native custom. So if the natives is heathens, why would they be practicing the same custom as the Israelites? The dietary law. They ate very healthy. Like I said, they didn't eat pork. They didn't eat like different birds that was like the prey. When you go to Leviticus 11, the Lord told us not to eat those things. They had a city of refuge. So if a person kills somebody, like in the Bible, if somebody kills somebody on accident, they had a city that they go to for refuge unto their whole tribe. Just like the Native Americans, they also had that. The burial of the dead, we covered that earlier, they restrained from touching the dead. The raising seed to a deceased brother, that was always practiced amongst the Israelites. So that's it on that. So now get the Lost Child of the Promised and read that, brother.
Waving, that's, this is page 364.
Go ahead.
Waving a banner high in the air.
No matter of fact, start right there, where the white people say, all right, bless be the name of the Lord.
Blessed be the name of the Lord,
uh-huh,
who has not made me an idolater,
uh-huh,
a barbarian,
uh-huh,
a Negro,
uh-huh,
an Indian.
Go ahead.
When suddenly we stopped, those Indians, he told himself, they are Hebrew.
What did the white folks say?
They are Hebrew.
No, Chinese.
They are Hebrew.
Japanese.
They are Hebrew.
No, heathens.
They are Hebrew.
Get to the point, go ahead.
Waving a banner high in the air.
Uh-huh.
The Indian guy soon was greeted by a puff of smoke.
Go ahead.
Far beyond the other bank of the river.
Continue.
In response to his signal, two men waited. Eventually, a canoe appeared, bearing three men and a woman, all of them Indian,
uh-huh,
to the place where Francisco and Montesinos were standing at the water's edge.
Continue.
The woman got off and spoke to Francisco in an Indian tongue. The Montesino could not understand, although he could perceive that he was being identified in the conversation.
Go ahead.
She then turned to her male companions to explain the situation.
Go ahead.
Upon hearing her words, they rose, went over to Montesino's, and to his utter astonishment said, Shema Yasha'ala, Alahayinahu. That's it.
So Shema Yasha'ala, Yahweh Elahayinahu, Yahweh Akkad. Go ahead.
Hear, O Israel.
Hear, O who?
Hear, O Israel.
What did the Americans say?
Hear, O Israel.
No, hear, O Chinese.
Hear, O Israel.
Go ahead.
The Lord is our God.
So, first of all, the Chinese, another thing, a point too, Slack here. Chinese and Japanese, they into eating dogs. The Americans ain't eating no dogs. Go ahead, read that again.
Hear, O Israel.
Uh-huh.
The Lord, our God. The Lord is one.
Uh-huh.
They have received in Hebrew the fundamental of credo of Judaism.
Uh-huh.
A brief conversation then ensued in their common ancestral tongue.
Uh-huh. Read that part right there.
They told him that they were themselves of the tribe of Reuben.
Well, they said it was Chinese.
They were themselves of the tribe of Reuben.
They claimed one of the tribes of Israel. how would they know the sons of Jacob if they're not descendants of Jacob? He trying to say, how they way over here on the other side of the world, and they talking about Reuben. Go ahead.
They told him that they were themselves of the tribe of Reuben,
uh-huh.
and that the tribe of Joseph lived on an island nearby.
Ephraim and Manasseh, Puerto Ricans and Cubans, lived on an island nearby. Now read that, Lamentations chapter 5, verse 1.
Lamentations chapter 5, verse 1.
Go ahead.
Remember, O Lord, what is come upon us.
Uh-huh.
Consider and behold our reproach.
Go ahead.
Our inheritance is turned to strangers.
Our what?
Our inheritance is turned to strangers.
Because the Americans are Israelites. And then their inheritance is turned to strangers. And there you got people say, I'm American. When this is their land, go ahead.
Our house is to aliens.
Our house is to what?
Our house is to aliens.
The white people came and took their house. Go ahead.
We are orphans and fatherless.
We are what?
We are orphans and fatherless.
There's an article that showed you that Native Americans are being adopted crazy. They along with the so-called blacks and Spanish. They begin adopted. A lot of white people be adopting natives. Go ahead.
Our mothers are as widows.
Uh-huh. They was killing the husbands. Go ahead.
We have drunken our water for money.
Wait. What did Native Americans have to do?
We have drunken our water for money.
Didn't they have to pay for their water now? Don't they gotta pay for their water? They drinking their own water for money. Like, hold on. Go ahead.
Our wood is sold unto us.
Our own stuff is sold to us. This is our tree. This is our forest. How the hell you trying to sell my... I can't build a house on my own land. Go ahead.
Our necks are under persecution.
Uh-huh.
We labor.
We what?
We labor.
Go ahead.
And have no rest.
Go ahead.
We have given the... We have
you know, that's going to fit that right there. You know, it's going right there. It ain't working sun up, sun down. Go ahead.
We have given the hand to the Egyptians.
Uh-huh.
And to the Assyrians.
Uh-huh.
To be satisfied with bread.
Continue.
Our fathers have sinned.
Uh-huh.
And are not. And we have borne their iniquity.
Go ahead.
Servants have ruled over us. There is
no... Wait, servants have what?
Servants have ruled over us.
Matter of fact, let me get this precept. I know we run out of time. Let me see where they Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 7. I have seen servants upon horses and princes walking as servants upon the earth. Read that part again.
Our fathers have sinned and are not, and we have borne their iniquities.
Uh-huh.
Servants have ruled over us.
Those servants, talking about the other nations, go ahead.
There is none that dogs deliver us out of their hands.
So that's it on that. Read verse 11 and 12.
Verse 11. They've ravished the women of Zion.
Didn't the so-called white men ravish the natives? Took their women and brutally raped them? Go ahead.
And the maids in the cities of Judah.
Uh-huh.
Princes are hanged up by their hand.
Didn't they do that to natives? Hung them up by the trees? Go ahead.
The faces of elders were not honored.
So they didn't respect the elders. They killed them as well. Now give me 2 Chronicles chapter 28, verse 8-11. And you keep reading this. Right there.
Francisco saw on the scene all he knew about these people from his own traditions.
Uh-huh.
His ancestors, to their eternal shame.
Go ahead.
Had indeed made war on them.
This is bar 55. The Central Library will be closing in 5 minutes.
Okay, go ahead.
His ancestors, to their eternal shame.
Uh-huh.
Had indeed made war with them.
So the white people did make war with the neighbors. Go ahead.
And persecuted them.
And persecuted, just like Christ said, you should be persecuted by all nations. Go ahead.
Only the sorcerers of his tribe.
The leaders, go ahead.
Have been perceived that they were a special people.
Deuteronomy 7:6 said we are a special people. Go ahead.
They had given warning that they should be left alone.
They're like, you gotta leave these natives alone. Because like the Bible says, he that touches you touches the apple of his eye. Go ahead.
The God of these children of Israel.
No, the children of Buddha.
Of these children of Israel.
No, Hindu.
Of these children of Israel.
Go ahead. That movie or that religion, that book, is nothing but Native Americans' records, and they made a religion out of it. That's why in that Book of Mormon it tells you that the Native Americans are Israelites. Go ahead.
At the end of days they will be lords of all the nations of the earth.
Isaiah 14:1 tells you that the Israelites is going to rule. That's when the Americans understood that, and the white people understood that too. The leaders of the white people knew that they was going to rule throughout the planet Earth. Go ahead.
One nation, come bringing many things to this land.
Uh-huh.
And after we have all been provided for,
uh-huh.
These children of Israel.
These children of who?
These children of Israel.
No, Native Americans.
These children of Israel.
Go ahead.
Will go forth from where they are now.
Where they are right now, North, South, Central America. Go ahead.
Or and reign over the whole earth as they once did.
They're going to come back. That's why it says Gad. A troop shall overcome you, but you shall overcome at the last. You will pay the other nations back for what they did. Now read that. Because a lot of people say, 2 Chronicles chapter 28, verse 8 through 11, a lot of people say, how can Native Americans be Israelites and they had the black Americans in slavery? Let's see if this happened in the Bible. Let's see. 2 Chronicles chapter 28, verse 8. Give me a moment.
2 Chronicles chapter 28, verse 8.
Go ahead.
And the children of Israel.
The children of who?
And the children of Israel.
Which is the northern kingdom. Go ahead.
Carried away captive.
Wait, wait. They carried away who?
Carried away captive.
They carried away somebody captives. Let's see who they enslaved. Go ahead.
Of their own, of their brethren.
Of their who?
Of their brethren.
No, the Native Americans cannot be Israelites because they enslaved the Negroes. Read that part again, verse 8.
And the children of Israel carried away captive of their brethren.
Of their who?
Of their brethren.
They enslaved their own brethren. Go ahead.
200,000.
200 who?
200,000.
Go ahead.
Women.
They enslaved women.
Sons.
Sons.
And daughters.
And daughters. Go ahead.
And took also away much spoil from them.
Uh-huh.
And brought the spoil to Samaria.
They brought them to the northern kingdom. Go ahead.
But a prophet of the Lord was there, whose name was
So the children of Israel, in the Bible, is known for putting their brothers in slavery. And when you keep on reading it, they put Judah in slavery. So when the Native Americans, they had no choice. They would either die or put them in slavery, but not all of them put them in slavery. Like the Seminole Indians, they brought them in, made them a fresh garments, and said, choose whatever wives you want. You my brother. And they fought wars together. You see what I'm saying? That because they knew that they was brothers. And they kept that brotherly love. Now give me 2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 3.
2 Corinthians chapter 4, verse 3.
Go ahead.
But if our gospel be hid, it's hid to them that are lost.
If this gospel is hid, if you can't understand what we coming out with, it's not for you. Simple as that. Go ahead.
In whom the God of this world hath blinded the midst of them which believe not.
Because you don't believe. So because you don't believe that those Native Americans and Spanish can't be my people, they look Chinese. I don't know where they get that from. But because you don't believe that, God hath blinded you. You will never be able to receive that. Go ahead.
Lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ.
Unless the Most High and Christ reveal it to you. Through the Holy Spirit, go ahead.
It's 5 o'clock. In the Minneapolis Central Library is now closed. The library will open again tomorrow, Sunday, at 12 noon.
Go ahead.
Thank you. Have a good night.
She shined unto them.
So now give me John 10:14-16. Give me Ezekiel 37.
John 10:14.
Go ahead.
I am the good shepherd. And know my sheep. And am known of mine.
So Christ knows who his sheep is. You got these Negroes all. I guess they're Christ. I guess they must be Christ and they know who Israel, who's not. Go ahead.
As the Father knoweth me. Even so know I the Father. And I lay down my life for the sheep.
Go ahead.
And other sheep I have, which are not of this fold.
Because the fold was he was talking about was Judah, Benjamin, Levi that was there in Jerusalem. Go ahead. He said, other sheep, go ahead.
Them also I must bring.
They're going to hear this gospel as well. Go ahead.
And they shall hear my voice.
And that's why Hispanics and Americans are hearing this truth. It's saying, I am Israel. They're not waking up. You don't see no Chinese over there. Chinese talking about, I'm an Israelite from the tribe of Ephraim. You don't see no Arabs over there saying, I'm from the tribe of Issachar. But you see so far Hispanics and Americans waking up. Because they are part of that lost sheep. Now give me Ezekiel 37, verse 21 and 23. You give me the last scripture.
Ezekiel chapter 37, verse 21.
Go ahead.
And say unto them, thus said the Lord God, Behold, I will take the children of Israel from among the heathen, whither they be gone, and I will gather them on every side, and bring them into their own land.
Go ahead.
And I will make them one nation.
He gonna make us one nation. So we gotta wrap it up. So if this gospel be hid, it's hid to them that are lost. You know what I mean? It's 5 o'clock, so we gotta wrap it up. So all praises to Yahweh, Hashem, Hamashiach, Yahweh Shai, Rock a thumb to all you brothers out there that's preaching this word sincerity and truth, and that's accepting the expansion of Americans as Israelites. Shalom to you, brothers. This is your brother Ephraim Michael Barr. Shout out to Thug Camp out of Minnesota, true Hebrews under God. Shalom.
Shalom.